The blindfolded figure of justice, weighing the scales, graces our courtrooms and our courthouses. We expect justice to be blind. We expect forensic experts to be impartial and to be agents of justice as well. And yet all too often, they are cops in lab coats. They work for the police. They receive all sorts of biasing information from the police.
My name is Itiel Dror, and I'm a cognitive neuroscientist. I'd like to say that forensic experts, in many ways, make honest mistakes and are subject to bias.
A wave of new research has shown just how deeply and easily biased even the most traditional and long thought to be reliable forensic methods can be, and how few crime labs have offered any precautions against this type of insidious bias.
In the forensic domain, we never know the ground truth. We never know what happened. We never know if and when a forensic examiner makes a mistake. And in fact, in the United States and many other countries, the vast majority of cases are plea bargain, right? We're talking 95% and above. So the forensic evidence is never questioned in court.
We can require blinding by bringing quality control into the very operation of a lab itself, by including blind tests in the cases that forensic examiners routinely see from day to day.
Forensic examiners and laboratories acknowledge the potential for bias, then they can take measures. I've published and others a whole range of measures within the existing system that doesn't require much more money, and they can think about it themselves. It's not very difficult or complicated.
Catching errors should be built into what a crime lab does. This is required for clinical laboratories because lives are at stake. It is a national scandal that for crime laboratories, these types of quality controls have never been required, even though life, liberty, and our very justice system hangs in the balance.